Good afternoon, everybody. I'm aware that I've already run out of my time, but may I go in my presentation? Yeah. Thank you for the introduction, Professor Yamagata. So I will talk about the Japan's contribution to UN decade of ocean science for SD. And my name is Tatsuya Watanabe, as introduced, and I'm small director for deep sea earth scientific research in the MEXT. Okay, I go in a very lean, short script version. Contribution from Japan. Yeah, this is the structure of my presentation. I am in charge of international affairs and ocean scientific drilling in the sea and earth division of the MEXT. But because I got involved in to the process of the IODE, I think I have to be clear about the Japan's contribution for that decade. And the second part will be very brief because of the Councillor Morishita's presentation was very comprehensive. That is the kind of personal view on how the contribution will be collated and further forged. So, the parenthesis one is a prelude part and now ongoing. This conference itself, I appreciate the efforts made by the Japan Coast Guard, Hydrographic and Oceanographic Department for organizing this event. Very successful. Regarding 1B, I understand that the UN University located in Tokyo and the IOC Secretariat and the MEXT Ministry found very common interest on ocean literacy, damage and risk reduction against disasters, including tsunami, and decade of ocean science. So if this one is successful and fruitful, or more opportunities may be explored. I hope it will happen. And second, number 2A, is kind of the commitment of the Japanese government to offer the host 3-day regional consultation workshop in Tokyo for the North Pacific Ocean Basin in this summer. And it will be organized by IOC Westpac, and I heard this will be the first regional consultation workshop for the decade process. So it will be a good test for us. And then consultation is going on between the IOC Secretariat and Japan on 2A and B. B is for the material for the outreach or the publicization. A very concrete contribution. Then, this slide is what Japan provided in terms of expertise directly relevant to the planning process. The 3A, the member to the EPG, Dr. Ogumaki over there, he will speak in his first presentation in the afternoon. And the others, I believe, more or less relevant to the decade and its planning process as appeared in the presentation by Dr. Riabini at the very beginning of this meeting. I have not listed the name of that expert here, but the main player is Dr. Shira, Dr. Shirayama of Jamstead. For the GOSR2, as we saw yesterday, and the ocean conference, and BDLJ process, and so on. The expert for the capacity development is myself. Then, let's try. And what I have to emphasize on this ocean policy of Japan, a basic plan of ocean policy of Japan, the decade is mentioned and well recognized at the point of the last May There are not so many elements to describe there, but yes, it is embedded in that basic plan. Then, yes, as Councillor Morishita explained, that the basic plan involves all the ministries, and for the ocean science part, I counted all the 181 items under the 8 ministries. And this is the kind of the old Japan system to call this challenge for the ocean science. Then, still, for the and the, for the sustainable development goals as a whole, the government of Japan established a strategy involving, again, all ministers and thus all ministries in December 2016, as shown in this slide. Sorry about so many small letters, but the I'd say that there is a kind of coherency between the basic ocean policy and this SDG strategies within the Japanese government. Then I just skip to the next slide. Yeah. So, yes. This is the core slide of this presentation. We will have the decade with the implementation plan aiming at goals and targets with indicators. The 14 has a special emphasis, and we saw the, I think the 14 goals out of 17 in our roadmap, revised roadmap for the decade. And yeah, we are very aware of the gap between the targets and indicators. But we have those ongoing processes in a kind of very IOC context. I picked up all those programs, and more or less those have the 10-year strategy or targets. And I think JEBCO is something very special that because it is very explicit about numerical target. The others do not necessarily have the numerical target, but they more or less they have kind of strategy for 10 years or so. And yesterday morning, when I saw the presentation by Dr. Barbier, could you recall that the cycling chart of the process that will happen during the decade, we will get involved new partners, stakeholders, and we will come up with new troubles and new solutions. So we do not have the real the goal or the outcome, the concrete outcome from the end of decade yet. But now I understand that is a kind of the decade is a much bigger the activities that we cannot define very definite goal yet. Anyway, the programs are designed to contribute to the SDGs, and Japan makes contribution for those activities. And of course, we have other activities, and we have the regular reporting system of the GOSR about the target 14A. So, I believe the colleagues, scientists, in this meeting, not only here, but the other IOC and UN member states and other partners in a very broad sense must be seen more or less similar landscape. And we may agree to the necessity and the usefulness of partnership collaboration. And then I believe we need to know what others are doing and need to find how we can collaborate. So now I see that this is the kind of thing. We have to understand what we are doing here and there, and the very first step of that cyclic activities. Yeah, but I made this presentation last 10 days ago. Then last week I learned there is kind of new movement from the academies. Probably Dr. Wematz, Professor Wematz may explain about that. This science 20. Science 20 is the kind of annual conference of the academies of the G20 countries. And they will convene a third conference this March, 6th March in Tokyo. And they are, I think, preparing a kind of communique. Just this year, it is only focusing on oceans. The science academies, not only in Japan, but all of the G20, agreed to take only ocean for this time. And the communique will be handed to the Prime Minister of Japan, the chair of the G20 for this July in Osaka. What I mean is that, these items are very IOC context things, but at the backdrop of these activities, we have big support from the academies and probably the society as well. Yeah. I'm running out of my time. Oh, yes, sorry. Yeah, collaborations. Partners will be much broader. Then, I skipped this slide. Yeah, making GeoSR is a kind of daunting job for the bureaucrats. For steps forward, for Japan, centralized soil initiatives are very unlikely, and correlations of relevant activity necessary and plausible, and then needed to explore ways to forge another additional activities specific for the decade, much more than the programs. Then, at this point of time, I can say that productive interaction, creating exchange of views with well-informed professionals are much appreciated. And during iterative regional and global planning process, and I believe that branding of decade might work as an enticement for to get meaningful stakeholders' participation and hopefully investment as well. Yeah, thank you. This is my presentation. I thank you.